ರೈಲ್ವೆ ಸಚಿವರಾದಂಥ ಶ್ರೀಯುತ ಸುರೇಶ್ ಪ್ರಭಾಕರ್ ಪ್ರಭುಜಿಯವರು ಉದ್ದೇಶಿಸಿ ಮಾತನಾಡಲಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ನಾವು ಐ ರಿಕ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಶ್ರೀ ಸುರೇಶ್ ಪ್ರಭಾಕರ್ ಪ್ರಭುಜಿ, ಆನರಬಲ್ ಯೂನಿಯನ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ರೈಲ್ವೇಸ್, ಟು ಅಡ್ರೆಸ್ ದ ಗ್ಯಾದರಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್.
Honorable Chief Minister Siddaramaiah ji, Honorable former Prime Minister of India, Honorable Devegowda ji, my good friend, colleague, and someone who represents Karnataka in the Parliament of India very forcefully, Mr. Anand Kumar ji, Honorable MPs, PC Mohan ji, Mr. DK Suresh, I am surprised wo hamare Raju Gowda ka naam, Mr. Raju Gowda ji, Mr. Muniappa ji, sabka naam, in case I am forgetting the name, but all of my good colleagues in the parliament, the minister who has always been in the government trying to champion the cause of industry, R.V. Deshpande ji, Sri Manju, Srimati Padmavati ji, Sri Jaluswami, Balkrishna ji, Muniratan ji, Nagaraya ji, Somashekhar ji, Revanna ji, Ramesh Babu ji, Kantara ji, Appa ji, Gowda ji, Srinivas Purti ji, Kante Gowda ji, Ramchandra Gowda ji, Gopal Swami ji, Mr. Vasu, and Sri Nagaraj ji, all my other distinguished friends and colleagues, and all my friends from media, and all those who have come for this program, I wish to welcome you and also thank you for coming here. Hum sab jante hain ki Karnataka ke vikas ke liye इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर ग्रोथ करने की बहुत जरूरी है, और उसी के ऊपर बल देकर पूरे देश में हमारे सम्माननीय प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी पूरी मात्रा में कम से कम 10% हमारे देश का जीडीपी इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर में निवेश किस तरह से किया जाएगा इसके ऊपर कार्रवाई कर रहे हैं. इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर में अहम निवेश जो होगा वो ज्यादा करके ट्रांसपोर्टेशन सेक्टर में होगा, क्योंकि हमने देखा है जैसे हमारे पड़ोसी देश चीन में भी हुआ था कि जब विकास की प्रक्रिया बड़ी तेज हो जाती है तो लोग बहुत कारणों से ज्यादा सफर करने के लिए भी उनको करना पड़ता है. People travel for business, people travel for pleasure, people travel to do their activities. As a consequence of this, there is a huge explosion that happens in transportation. And to ensure that we take care of this, we have decided to invest $146 billion, 8,56,000 crores, into the railways over the period of 5 years. I am very happy to say that typically in the railways we used to invest 40,000-50,000 crores a year. The amount which we are raised only in 2.5 years to 3,50,000 crores, and therefore we are on track to achieve the target of 8,56,000 crores. And I am very sure in the course of next few years we will not only reach the target, we will exceed the target. Because besides this, we are also trying to make investments into other areas which are not mentioned there. For example, the new station redevelopment program, which is going to have an investment of almost 1 lakh crore. And we have included some of the stations in Karnataka also for redevelopment, which will not only give a better quality of experience to the passengers, but also ensure more revenues for the railways. So this is one program that we are going ahead with in an aggressive way. Also, we are ensuring that in the course of next few years, we'll increase the doubling and tripling of railway tracks in a significant way. I'm happy to say that in the first 70 years, the number of doubling that we did was 77,000 kilometers. In the last 2.5 years, we have exceeded the target of the cumulative doubling that was done. We are increasing it in the course of last only 2.5 years. 17% of India's total network handles 60% of traffic. 60% of entire railway traffic is coming on only 16-17% of railway's network. And therefore, if you do not do doubling, the entire line gets saturated, and the consequences that we are suffering today of not having enough punctuality, not having enough speed, not to be able to put more trains, it is all because the saturated network cannot handle it anymore. So we decided to increase the doubling and tripling, and I'm happy to say that all the most of the money that is going in that direction. Second important issue is electrification. In the next 5 years, we'll double the electrification that has been done in the course of last several decades. What is the benefit of this? The cost of energy will go down, the speed will increase, it is good for the environment. In first year, we have saved almost 4,000 crores on energy cost. The target is to save 41,000 crores in the course of next 10 years, which will bring down the cost of energy consumption in India, in railways, which will also ensure that profitability of railways will go up. Along with the station redevelopment program, which will bring in non-fare revenue, we are also working on making sure that non-fare revenue directed, which is first time created in the railways, will earn as much as 17,500 crores. So all of this put together will bring railways to a better place, and for which number of new initiatives are launched, I am not taking about all that. But I am very happy to say that for state of Karnataka, in the course of last 2 years, we have done 202 kilometers of doubling. We also done 548 kilometers of electrification in this zone. 92 kilometers of new lines have been commissioned for the state of Karnataka. 6 new crossing stations have been commissioned, and additional lines have been commissioned at 8 stations. Doubling work in all major sections are in progress, and between Bengaluru and Mumbai, which will become double line in the next 3 years. New station buildings and second entry at KSR Bengaluru Station, Yesvantpur and Krishnanarajapuram stations have been made. New building at Yelahanka is coming up, and new hall stations at Hudi to facilitate our booming and the industry of which we are very proud, the IT industry, the Whitefield, it is coming up in a big way. We have started car shed commission at Banaswadi, and a capacity of diesel shed at KGM has been upgraded to 125 to 150 locos so that more and more locos can be manufactured. 7 bi-weekly, 3 weekly and 7 daily passenger trains have been introduced in last 2 years. Onboard housekeeping services have been introduced in 43 trains, which would mean people can SMS and their coach will be clean. 32 ROBs and 137 RUBs have been constructed in this zone in the last 2 years. 64 unmanned level crossing and 97 unmanned level crossings have been closed. So I am just giving a few instances about work that has been done in Karnataka in the course of last few years. I am very happy to say that new line which has been constructed, our former Prime Minister, when he was a Prime Minister, he had started certain projects, but you can imagine they were delayed for decades, and therefore we have put it on an expeditious mode. All the old pending projects which were sanctioned by any government, but we are giving priority to them and try to complete them, and therefore, as I said, we are putting money only into doubling, tripling, and not just trying to do something new lines all the time. So this will result into a substantial benefit to the passengers, to the country as a whole, and along with that, the high-speed Wi-Fi which are being started, everything is done through a digital platform. We have started two stations where everything will be digital. And yesterday in Hyderabad, I launched, I think, more than 30 stations which will go digital. So all of this put together, we are putting into reality the mission of a Prime Minister of making India digital India. And that all will make sure that there will be better transparency, efficiency, user-friendly operation, and this is what we are trying to do. I am very happy to say in the next few months, very soon, we launch two important projects. One for the city of Bengaluru, the foundation stone for the suburban railway will be put in the course of next few months itself. In fact, I just requested Honorable Chief Minister and thank him. He has provided in his state budget the money for it. We'll make sure that we start this project. See, Mr. Moily is also here. Mr. Moily, our great leader, is also here. So I will make sure that we'll start all this project in the course of next few years, a few months. Also, a direct train between Bengaluru and Mangaluru will be started, cutting down the travel time by at least 4 hours, and overnight train will be started. And as desired by our leaders, we'll give at the appropriate time, appropriate name, which will ensure that Karnataka's pride is reflected into this. So we'll definitely make sure that we'll work on all the issues, and I look forward to working closely with the people of Karnataka to make sure that Karnataka gets what it deserves. Karnataka will be one of the fastest growing states in next few years' time. For that, we lay down the foundation of having proper infrastructure by doing everything that is necessary from the side of the railway. So thank you very much. Jai Hind, Jai Karnataka.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸರ್. ಈಗ ನಮ್ಮನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಉದ್ದೇಶಿಸಿ ಮಾತನಾಡಬೇಕೆಂದು ಮಾನ್ಯ ಸಂಸದರು ಹಾಗೂ